business, regardless of what it is, you have a product or a service, if you're so good at it, there will come a point people will notice. When people start noticing, they see value in it, they start paying for it also. And business is just a byproduct of the amount of value you give, and the amount of value you give is just a byproduct of how much people will pay for it as well.
We don't give allowances to our kids.
If challenges will come, tapos pera lang habol mo,
it hanap will be, ka na ibang kikita.
Tsaka it will be parang madaling mag-quit kasi kung pera lang, it will be hard.
Add value to people.
Galing.
Add value to your family. Add value to whoever you encounter.
Wow. Hi everyone, we're in for a special treat. We have a commercial model with us. Nescafe?
Coffee Mate
commercial model of the what year was this?
Nung hindi pa born yung audience.
Ah, talaga? Pero ngayon, you're a mom, yes? How many kids?
We have four kids.
Four kids.
I have four kids.
Okay.
Yeah, 13,
11,
6, and 3.
Okay, who are all in homeschool?
Yes.
Yes? Now, there are a lot of mommies also watching here. Anong pinaka-technique nyo how to budget your money na you are a mom with a lot of kids? Four, not okay. Everyone has four. Average, yun, dalawa na nga lang minsan. Isa.
Please subscribe to Marvin Gamo's channel.
Yes.
Hit the bell.
Yes.
Or smash the bell.
Smash the bell so you get updated.
And stay till the end to find out who the subscriber of the day is.
So enjoy the video. We're going to interview her. You're going to learn so much insights from how smart and so much wisdom. And the wisdom that she has. Oh, super.
Thanks, Sam. Thanks, friend.
Naman, super.
Alam, feeling ko malakas loob ko dahil homeschool kami for one. So I think malaking bagay yon sa in terms of budget, in terms of where the money goes.
Mm-hmm.
Ano bang anong
so homeschool is anong pinaka advantage ng homeschool? Is it really cheaper than going to a traditional school, or is it because I've seen a lot of people na nag-homeschool because number one, they homeschool because madami daw bullying sa traditional schools. Number two, sobrang traffic, they don't want their kids to go through the grind na every day papasok sila sa school na gigising ng maaga. Yun. And then I haven't explored yet yung cost niya. Is it super cheaper
it
or
can
how
go
does it
cheap?
Go?
Okay. It can also go as high as you want it to go.
Because
ngayon uso na, I guess, when we started homeschooling, wala pa naman masyadong, hindi pa uso.
Okay.
So, in terms of support, in terms of whatever classes that are available for homeschoolers, wala, sariling
sikap. Okay.
Ngayon, ang dami ng tutorials, ang dami ng programs for homeschooling families. So, if you enroll in all those things,
it becomes more expensive.
Mas mahal din siya. So, it depends, I guess, on where you want to focus your budget. It goes back to values. It goes back to perspective also.
Okay. What's the biggest advantage for people who want to go into homeschool?
I think for me, it's culture building.
Mm-hmm.
It's you get the primary influence lives ng kids mo, especially in the foundational years.
Okay.
And the memories, walang kapalit yon. For me, kasi even when I started the family, alam ko window lang the time that I have with my
with
kids.
Okay.
And then I'll send them off.
Mm.
So, contrary to what others think about homeschool, it's not actually protecting them or sheltering them.
Okay.
Diba? It's not na, dahil takot ka to send them out. That's why you homeschool. Actually, you want to prepare them because you know you will send them out.
So, the biggest advantage of doing homeschool is you get to parang yung values na gusto mo, you get to instill them. It's not, so it's a misconception pala na if you want to save money, homeschool na lang, not necessary.
Yes. Okay. I think I would go so far as to say if the reason for homeschooling is financial, then I don't think it's reason enough to say that sige homeschool tayo para makatipid.
Okay. Pero yung payment for I guess baon, going to school, transportation, books, it goes somewhere also, no? Pag homeschool sila.
Yeah, wala ka masyadong kailangan na.
Okay.
So yun yung malaking tipid.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, we don't give allowances to our kids. So even ngayon, they do have extracurricular for PE, like ballet, mga special classes na hindi ko lang natuturo. But still, we don't give them allowances. Like, okay. Magbaon ka kung gusto mo. Kung gusto mo nang kumain sa labas, magtrabaho ka para makatakas sa labas.
Ito, interesting. So you don't give your kids baon. So how do you give them jobs? How do you help them make money naman?
So we have basic ano, diba? Like as part of the being a member of the family, contribute ka naman. So we don't pay them for that. But there are other jobs na pwedeng extra that we can assign. Like now they help me. I teach childbirth preparations. I have my classes. So my eldest daughter is in charge of the behind the scenes. So siya yung sa mga all the technical stuff.
Okay.
Siya yung mga ganon, sa computer, whatever. Mm-hmm. My other daughter is in charge of running the event, our mini event. So yun, may sweldo sila doon.
So the best way for them para ako rin kasi I was given allowance lang for school, just enough lang yung kakainin ko. Pero everything else na gusto kong bilhin, rubber shoes or gusto kong bumili ng basketball cards ng bata ko, I had to also work for it. Ako taga-car wash ng kotse or taga-linis. Based on people that you've seen also grow up, what's the biggest advantage if they're raised that way that money's not given to them now?
I think one of the... Hindi ko alam kung it's a thing of the more current generation, but one of the things I'm really hoping to... ano ba tawag mo doon?
Instill?
No, siguro to go na yung nakikita ko na marami ngayon. I don't want to talk generalizations, pero there is a lot of consumer mentality that everything comes easy kasi ngayon. Okay. Everything's instant, everything's fast.
Okay.
So in terms of acquiring stuff, parang kung gusto ko to makukuha ko agad.
Okay.
So I hope not to raise my kid that way. I hope to instill yung na it's not yung against, I guess, against entitlement, against consumerism na parang, okay, dito lang ako, everything's handed to me, everything comes easy. Kasi tayo naman, we became resilient because things did not come easy.
Okay.
Yeah, parang, mahirapan ka, you suck it up.
You slug it up.
Ganon, di ba? Okay. Parang ganon. Hindi yung, ay, ganon ba? Sige, tulungan kita. Sad ka na ba dyan sa ginagawa mo? Parang ganon na...
I have a question on that. Kasi may mga ano ngayon na kids are raised soft daw. Meaning, for example, some competitions sa schools, there are participation trophies, everyone gets an award na parang yung time natin, it's either you get first place, second place, or third place, tapos nothing na parang they don't want kids to lose. That's why when they get into the real world now, they start their own business. Tapos, na-realize sila, di pala ito ganito kadali. They start to quit.
Walang incentive agad.
Parang they grew up with the mentality na everyone wins pala. So, if the first time they don't win, parang masakit.
I don't know if it's... Siguro, we were raised a certain way. Mm-hmm. And some of us, our tendency is... Either we would not want our kids to go through a certain, di ba parang ganito ako nila, so I don't want my kids to go through what I went through. Na nahirapan ako, gusto ko sana to. So I guess in a way, the tendency is to rescue our kids. But by rescuing them, we're not giving them the resilience. We're giving them a disservice actually if we keep rescuing them. Na, yun nga, parang kailangan, I make sure you're okay, self-esteem mo. Like, okay yun that you build them up, right? But if it's based on, paano ba? Yung parang, I guess, yung masyado rin nakatahi yung self-esteem and self-worth sa performance. Na. So now, I want to make sure na okay ka. So I will just really make sure na feeling mo okay yung performance mo lagi. So kahit di naman yung...
Parang people attach them, yung whatever they achieve, that's their value. Dapat hindi ganun, di ba?
So ngayon, yung identity is in their performance. So because I want them to be okay with the, to na okay yung self worth nila, which is dahil nga aling sa performance, di lagi kong i-upload yung performance nila, lagi kong I want to di ba yung ganong feeling na that was good, yeah, stop parang ganon.
What's a good way to educate them na they lost, they failed, pero they know that they failed, pero not also yung magiging ano naman to demean them na oy I'm a loser parang ganun. Mm. So how do you tell kids na ganun?
Yes. Ako din kasi no, okay. Galing ako sa takot ako magkamali. Kasi nga, link yung identity ko and how I see myself with okay. My performance. So I guess it's going back to where is your identity?
Okay.
Who are you?
Okay.
Diba? Parang, it's always going back. And ako, hindi ko matanggal yung faith ko in as I parent my kids. Even as a mom. Mm. I really think it is hard to be a mom kung tanggalin ko yung aspect of my identity is not how I perform okay. as a mom. Kasi okay. otherwise, I would make sure my kids are okay. Kasi okay. that would yeah, dictate yeah, how I am as a person.
Okay.
Diba? Parang ganon. Mm. So, konektado siya lahat na we point them na your identity is not based on your performance, but not based on your achievements. Point them back to
the value that Christ placed
yes.
in them. At ito interesting. Ako, I've been hammering this to people that ako naman baliktad. I like to. No one likes to fail. Pero when I fail, parang it's something that I welcome because I'm not scared to fail also. Because it allows me to learn from it, and then it's a springboard for me to do better later on. And I've seen it. The things that I've siguro done properly today is mainly because I failed on that before.
You made mistakes and learned from them.
And minsan kasi para sa akin, it's become hard for people not to try things because they're scared of failing. Mm. And I've seen so many people na ganun, Marvin, I want to try this business, pero what if I fail? Anong isipin ng pamilya ko? Anong isipin ng mga kaibigan ko? What if I quit my job tapos it does not really pan out well? What will they think? What will they think about me? Or ganun, to make it super simple. Because I've been doing vlogs, a lot of people have been approaching Marvin. I want to do this vlog. Tapos they make one, then they see. Hindi naman, they see a nasty comment lang sa comment section, and then they stopped already. Sabi ko, don't mind them. It always goes back also to value. Na your value should not be based on how people perceive and what they say about you as well. Okay. Anyways, back to you. You've been married for how many years?
Almost 15 years. Hindi pa yun matagal. We have a okay. long way to go.
Long way to go. Tama yun. Now, from that time, when you got married, what were you doing before for that 15 years? What were you focusing on?
I have been a full-time stay-at-home
okay.
homeschooling mom up until 2 years ago. Almost 3 years ago.
Now, this is what's interesting. So, 3 years ago, you started a practice, a business.
Yes, related okay. to childbirth.
Okay. Which is tell me more about it. What's that, naman?
I want, because parenting, anything that has to do with parenting, educating kids and other moms, that's a passion of mine.
Okay.
So I finally started with something that I have been wanting okay. to do ever since I gave birth to my firstborn.
Okay.
So ang tagal noon, no? Hanggang na finally yon. Yun yung one of those things na okay, bala na. Kung nagkamali o kung hindi po mato, go
okay,
na.
No. So how did you know it was a business? How did it start? What ano?
Business na nga ba?
Hindi pa ba? Di ko alam ano na. Full
yeah, it's
blown.
Official
oh.
naman na siya.
Oh, yeah.
And what do you mean, how did I know?
Pero how did you know it was something that if I'm good at this, kasi this is what I believe in. Business, regardless of what it is, you have a product or a service. If you're so good at it, there will come a point people will notice. When people start noticing, they see value in it, they start paying for it also. And business is just a byproduct of the amount of value you give. And the amount of value you give is just a byproduct of how much people will pay for it as well. So, yeah, how did...
Very well said.
So, my question is, when did you know that there was a need? When did you find out that this need, someone's willing to pay me for it? And number three, para mo nalaman na magaling ka dun. Kasi kung pwedeng passionate ka dun, kung di ka magaling, no one right. will pay you eh. Oh.
So I wanna take off from what you said.
Okay.
Na you add value.
Mm.
So even before, okay. I wasn't trained yet to do this. So I got my certifications in the US.
Okay.
So but before I got my training, I have been doing this. I have been talking to moms. Mm. I've been gathering moms and teaching them about childbirth, about parenting. Through the years.
So they call it like a childbirth consultant?
Birth coaching.
Birth coaching.
Coach.
Okay.
Yes.
So, yun yung
nauna.
So,
kinagawa ko na siya. And just,
okay.
I also believe that na just add value. Add value. office. Parang wala lang. As a friend, I would do that. And then I realized, oh nga, if I want to be able to help more people who are outside my circle of influence, I better get trained para I can add more value to others.
Wow.
So that's how it started.
Ako, that's, just to share, no, that's how I started also. I just wanted investing. I just wanted entrepreneurship. I just wanted finance. Then, kahit kinakausap ko, parang kwentuhan lang. And then I found out liking it. And a lot of people liked it. As a lot of people liked it, that's when I studied more. And that's what you've been doing. So, kaya, sobrang galing. Minsan lang magkaroon ng commercial model na nagsabi nun. Oh. Anyways, while you started learning, when did you figure out, sige, gagawin ko na rin tong career? And when do I figure out, sige, I'll start charging for this also?
Oh, the charging part was, kasi sanay ako.
By the way, I'll put the link below if you wanna contact her. Yes. Link down below.
Ah, sanay ako ever since. I just do things out of love.
Okay.
You know? And I got to the point that I realized I had to charge kasi I would set aside time, right? And kasi I put value. So I would block off my entire days. And merong dahil libre, would message me last minute.
Cancel.
Sorry, something came up. So I realized the charging part, it is because I put value, I value my time, I value what I have to offer. And that's why I will charge. So dun na renew yung mind ko na it's not charge ka para kumita ka. No, because I put value in this. And hopefully you see, if you really believe also in this, you will also value it. So in terms, so it became the money aspect came from dahil okay, it's putting value to my time and what I have to offer.
That's why you're doing well. If you notice it, guys, for those who've been watching all of our videos here, those that do well, when they start something, they don't do it for the money, and money is just a byproduct. Of course, it's not wrong to make money, it's not wrong to earn, it's not wrong to make a living or do businesses. Pero if your primary intention is not just the money, I think ano eh, it will be easier kasi it won't be starting something is not easy. If challenges will come tapos pera lang habol mo,
it hanap will be, ka na ng ibang kikita.
Oh, tsaka it will be parang madaling mag-quit kasi kung pera lang, it will be hard. So ngayon, when you started charging, did people acquire your service naman?
I actually had more people outside my circle of influence or my friends. Kasi dati, friends.
Okay.
So when I started charging, kabalik na rin eh. So people, dun ko mas nakita, okay, people actually put value. Mas parang, in short, mas naniwala sila na okay, totoo.
Kasi legit,
hindi ito no? friends lang.
Okay.
Parang ganun.
Okay.
So kahit yung mga hindi ko kakilala, they took notice.
Okay. Tapos, what year was that naman when you, sige, I'll charge already, and then people started to notice it that you were getting more and more clients.
That was last year na.
Last year na. Okay.
Beginning of last year.
Whoa. Tapos, so after that, what's your next step? What do you plan to do? You're gonna do more consulting? You're gonna, I actually don't know how it works
really
now. What's the flow? Okay.
So I really love teaching and journeying with parents. So andam ko nandun pa rin yung...
It's like a seminar or...
I do workshops.
Ah.
Yeah. So we'll see where that will lead me.
Okay.
Kung ano yung workshops pa na pwede kong i-offer.
Galing.
Yeah, pero does that's it take, the direction.
Pero you are homeschooling your kids. Tapos you're doing this at the same time. Kaya?
My kids actually helped me.
So they're learning entrepreneurship also.
Yes.
Okay.
So my daughter, who's into events, she's the one who's managing the program and getting coordinating with the people. So my other daughter who likes computer stuff, she's the one in charge of the technical stuff.
Okay. When is the time that you're supposed to give your kids allowance? How do you know what age that parang okay na sila bigyan, they can be responsible for it?
I wouldn't say age yung basis namin. There were times that we thought, okay, ready na. And then we've had to take it back. Parang ganon.
Ah, talaga?
Parang level of maturity.
Okay.
Same with phones and gadgets. We didn't give them phones until. Tapos yung phones na bigay namin, yung pangtawag lang talaga.
Okay, okay.
Parang ganon. Pero may times pa rin na, hindi pa rin kasi tawag na siya ng tawag.
Friends.
Okay naman kasi lola niya, okay. Yung mga ganon.
Okay.
Whoa. Pero so we would base it on their ability to take responsibility. And like I said, we didn't really call it allowance. We wanted them to take ownership
of money.
Na it's not parang it didn't come easy for them. So kasi dati I remember a time na kala nila pag nag-withdraw sa ATM, it just parang comes hindi out. Nila naisip okay. na may pinanggagalingan dapat, may deposit dapat. So for them, well, kung wala sa budget or walang money, why not get lang from the ATM? Parang ganon. So that's when I realized it has to be concrete for them na, ah, okay, may hard work involved and then I earn money and then I budget it and then I'm able to spend money.
Okay.
Parang ganon. So, kung kaya nilang i-comprehend yun. But I do remember that even when they were young, we would give them money for them to, for the purpose of them to know how to budget it.
Okay.
So example, or kahit hindi nila pera, pero as a family, ito yung money natin as a family. What do we do with this? So, let's put it, that's concrete, may jars. Okay.
Oy, budgeting
10%,
yan. Okay.
Let's put it sa tay.
Okay.
10%, let's put it sa giving fund. 10%, parang ganun. So, we made it yung easy lang. Kung bata pa, like 6 years old, 5 years old, 10 pesos.
Okay.
Piso sa ganyan. Yung mga ganun lang, maliliit. Start galing. Small. So little steps and hanggang before you know it, they actually get the concept before you realize it.
Pastor Dennis, your husband, wrote the book and we have videos about him. I'll put the link below as well about being rich for life. What's the best thing that you've learned on how you can be rich for life from the wife of Mr. Rich for Life as well.
Pressure ako dun.
Oh.
I think it's really a mindset.
It's
the mindset, the perspective, being in terms of being rich. It's really as you could have all the money, you could have a lot of resources, but if the mindset
it's
is
not there.
Lack, the mindset is I have to acquire because I need to have more,
okay.
then you'll never be rich or feel. So, even in terms of budgeting, that's I've seen a shift in my own perspective. Kasi lumaki ako, parang kailangan. Kala ko magaling ako mag-budget kasi or kala ko wise ako and being a good steward ako because I would really be so detailed in budgeting. And it was my husband who pointed out sabi niya, poverty mindset yan.
Because that's interesting. Okay.
It's a fear of running out. It's a fear of being in lack.
Okay.
And so I've had to break that. Even with our kids.
So what shifted in your budget that it wasn't anymore a poverty mindset?
I guess it also comes from knowing who my source is.
Okay.
So even the money, the job, whatever business you're in, it's a resource. It's not the ultimate source.
Wow.
And when I got that, it freed me, it liberated me. Na, oh man, no, I can move in generosity.
That you're...
I can move in... Na hindi siya rin yung feeling rich. Kasi kung... Even yung kung magastos ka masyado, hindi siya dahil feeling rich eh. Minsan, habang meron ako, go.
Go na.
Yung iba naman, gano'n. Okay. So, really
super mindset. Extreme naman. Galing. So, what you're trying to say also that whatever money's coming your way, that's a stream but it's not your source. It's a channel for you to have money but that's not the ultimate parang reservoir saan galing
it's not the ultimate source.
Okay.
It's also not the ultimate end.
Okay.
Acquiring money is also not the end. What's the goal of having money? Yun din parang it's again back to mindset and perspective.
Galing. Ito siguro tinatanong naman lahat ng tao. When you got your commercial deal, what did you do with the money? Did you invest it? Did you save it? Or nawala ka agad?
Okay, very good question.
Okay.
Though, because that's interesting.
Okay.
It was when we were raising funds for our church building.
What year was this, by the way?
Yes. See, hindi ko na ako maalala, no? But medyo matagal-tagal.
Okay.
I do remember we just completed our emergency fund.
Okay.
And then we both felt, husband and wife, both felt we needed, not that we needed, but we felt that emergency fund was to be given for our building fund. So
galing.
Kami parang, what? Kakatapos na emergency fund. We've been saving up for it. Tapos mapupunta sa building fund.
This is when you were Green Hills or not yet?
Green Hills.
Okay.
So we felt that as leaders of Green Hills, we wanted also to tayo yung unang mag-pour out dito, magsasow ng seed dito. So by faith, we gave the emergency fund.
Wow.
Tapos dumating yung deal na yon.
Okay.
The commercial.
Oh.
commercial
mode, guys.
So bumalik lang, napuno namin ulit.
So everything went to the emergency fund.
Tapos yung sobra, napunta sa... So we have ano, the emergency fund muna, and then investments, and giving fund.
Galing.
Yun.
Okay. Do you have any questions pa?
Napuno lang din, ang galing. We've been saving up for years.
Okay.
Tapos...
In one go,
in
boom.
In one go, dahil we both felt that we responded in obedience.
Wow.
Napuno rin ulit.
To end na lang, what's your tip for moms who... have been staying at home for quite some time, pero parang nakita nila, parang it's nice also to start something that I'm passionate about.
First, I guess, is embrace your the stage in life that you're in, the season that you're in. Kasi, like ako, I waited for more than a decade before I finally launched it. But in the process, you still stay faithful where, kung ano yung season mo, stay faithful kung nasan ka, be there. And, I firmly believe no season is wasted.
Wow.
So, even if you're there, feeling mo dormant season yan, walang nangyayari, you're learning, you're growing as a person in that season. When the time is right, everything will just fall into place.
Wow.
Na okay, your story, your life, being a mom, being a wife, running your home, that is part of your story. That's part of the journey. That's molding your character. That's molding you. So hindi wasted season yon. Like if I should say that, kasi yung iba parang sayang yung inaral ko, yung mga hindi siya. What I'm doing now, lahat yun, lahat nung akala ko walang nangyayari, akala ko sa bahay lang ako, lahat yun, kasama yun doon, kasama yun. Okay, sige mamaya.
So, okay, sige. So, that's it for now. Thank you so much for this. She'll have her own YouTube channel, also stay tuned in the next few months. Bye everyone.
Thank you.